I was using, back in 97, you got to remember there was no trenbolone. Okay. No one was making their own trenbolone yet, really. Not that I knew of, at least. I was using like, at that point we were getting testosterone, in bottles, 10 CC bottles from Steris. That was the Steris connection. That was the United States. It came right from the pharmacy in the US. Greg Valentino talks about it all the time. I was using like 200 milligrams, maybe even 300 milligrams, like, you know, four times a week or something like that, three, four times a week of that. I was using, I was getting Parabolone, which was the trenbolone we used back then. It was from France. They were in ampules. They were 76 milligrams per amp. We would use like two to three. The last 3-4 weeks, I would use three of them. I thought I was a big shot, you know. And we'd use that. We would use injectable Winstrol amps. They were little, you know, they look like little milk bottles you'd shake up. We'd do 50 milligrams every other day of that. The last 2 weeks, I would do my halotestin in 20 milligrams. They were little green, little mints. They looked like they came right from a U.S. pharmacy. I was taking Humatrope at the time, which was an American growth hormone. I was using about 3 to 4 IUs a day for that show. And let me think if there's anything else I was taking. I think I was actually on a little bit of insulin too. I used to take some insulin because I was eating a lot of food, but not a lot. Like I was taking like 3 or 4 units in the morning, 3 or 4 units like 6 hours later or something like that with the GH. Because I would get very insulin resistant, you know. And I didn't check my blood sugars back then because you couldn't just buy a cheap glucose monitor back then. I just knew when my blood sugars, I wasn't absorbing my food. I was really flat. So I believe it or not, I did use insulin, very small amounts for that show. And I think it was just because, once again, I think I probably, from the GH, I was running a little bit of high blood sugars. I wasn't absorbing my food. And once again, I have no data to support that other than how I felt. I used clenbuterol, not a ton of it, probably like maybe like 20 micrograms, like 3 or 4 times a day. And I was on probably about 50 micrograms of Cytomel. I didn't really need the T3, but I felt that it made everything work better. Like the GH and the clenbuterol work better. And that's why I used it rather than for fat burning purposes. I would use that. And I'm trying to think if there was anything else that I was using at that point, like anything exotic that I had access to. I really wasn't a big orals person, so I wasn't using any orals. I think that's it. You know, I think I had Primabol and acetate tabs. They were 25 milligrams a piece. They came from Germany. And I think I was doing 4 of those a day the last like 6 weeks because they only lasted like 2 or 3 hours in the system. So I would do 25 milligrams every 3 hours during the day, which came out to about 3 or 4 pills a day. And I really liked those. I felt good on those. They were the only oral that has no toxicity because they're acetate. They're not 17 alpha alkylated. So I felt comfortable using those that I wasn't like toxifying my body. And they didn't make me feel bad. A lot of orals always, I didn't do well on orals. They would just make me feel like I didn't want to eat or anything like that. That was the cycle. But you know what? You got to remember all the stuff came from either European or American pharmacy. It was all 100% legitimate and good. And you didn't have to do excessive amounts. And you know what? Quite frankly, if I would have told people what I was taking back then, they would have said that was excessive. They thought that I was an extremist doing those dosages. I just knew that was the effective dosages that worked. And once again, because guys had a lot of different theories about how much you should take back then. I never thought to take 8 or 10 or 12 IUs of GH. No one did that. I didn't think to take 2,000 milligrams of testosterone. No one did that. I didn't think to take 5 vials of Parabol. No one thought to do that. If you took 3, that was like, you only did that the last couple of weeks, you know? So that was like a top level cycle then. And I think a lot of the pros were doing similar type stuff like that. No one really pushed the envelope back then. It was all about training and diet. And that's the truth of the matter, you know?